says for Buddha's sake, he's be willing for sword.
Great best. He speak no harm of Buddha's self. Think about the tyrant.
Nay, that's certain. We are blessed that Rome is rid of him.
Peace. Let us hear what Antony can say.
Stay, Romans. Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. I come to buy Caesar, not to praise him. The evil that men do lives after them, and the good is often interned in their bones. So let it be with Caesar. All proof does noble assent that Caesar was a magus, and if this was so, it was a grievous fault. And grievously Caesar has answered it. Here under Brutus and all other women, come I to speak in Caesar's behalf. He was my friend, faithful, but just to me. Caesar has brought many captives home to Rome. Who is ransomed in the master's tomb? When the poor have cried, Caesar has wept. Ambition should be made of stone stuff. Didn't this Caesar's in ambition? But Brutus says he was ambition, and Brutus is an honorable man. You all have seen at the lubricant. And thrice presented him the kingly crown, and he thrice refused. Was this ambitious? Didn't this Caesar seem ambitious? But Brutus says he was ambitious, and Brutus is an honorable man. Speak I not to disprove what Brutus says, but I'm here to speak what I do know. You all loved him once, without fault. Then what cause beholds you then to mourn of it? My heart isn't there with Caesar. I must pause till he comes back to me.
Methinks that there is much reason in his say.
If thou consider rightly of the matter, Caesar had great wrong.
Has he, masters? I fear there was a worse come in his place.
Mark day he worse. He would not take the crown. Therefore, this sudden was not ambitious.
If it be possible, some will here abide him.
Peace. His eyes are red as fire with weeping.
There is not a nobler man in Rome than Antony.
Now mark it. He began again to speak.
But yesterday, Caesar must have stood against the wall. And now, he lies there. Oh, masters, if I was disposed to steal your mind and soul to mutiny and rage, I must do Brutus wrong, I must do Caesar wrong, that I had choose to wrong myself, the dead, as I have drawn, as I had drawn such honorable men. Here is a parchment with Caesar's seal. It was his will. I found it in his closet. Let but the calmness here, which pardon I must not be. Because you are not stones, you are not wood, you are humans. It will inflame you, it will burn you, it will make you mad. I must not read the will.
We hear the will. Read it, Mark Antony.
The will.
We will hear Caesar's will.
Stay, countrymen, stay. I have overshot myself. I fear the honorable men who have stabbed Caesar. I do fear.
Read us the will. We'll hear it, Antony. You shall read us the will. Caesar's will.
Be patient, gentlewoman. If you want me to read the will, then make a ring around the corpse of Caesar. Shall I descend?
Come down.
You shall have me.
A ring, stand round.
Stand from the ears. Stand from the body.
If we all have tears, prepare them to shed them now. You all remember this mantle. I remember when he first wore it. That was a summer evening in his tent, when he came by defeating the Nerevees. Stay, countrymen, stay. Look at this place. We have Brutus stabbed, who was beloved of Caesar. You all know Brutus was the angel of Caesar. And when Caesar's coin stabbed, in gratitude he fell. What a fall it was, my countrymen, what a fall.
Let not a traitor live.